Hey, and welcome back to number 6 of our Growth Insight series, where our community and team test out the best tools for you and share the best resources. And as usual, we're gonna keep the best for last. Every week, we're going to kick off with our favorite tools. Raul, one of the students from our last Growth Tribe Academy, created FadFeed. FadFeed is a Chrome extension for Facebook that basically fills your whole Facebook feed by getting rid of your grandmother's posts and replaces it with ads instead. It's ad inspiration heaven, or hell, you decide. Now let's stay on Facebook a little bit with this fun little gimmick. Data Selfie is a free Chrome extension that shows you all the data Facebook is storing on you. Slightly scary, but also extremely insightful. Check it out. Thanks to Alina for sharing brand24.com. It's actually a competitor to one of my favorite tools, mention.com. Brand24 gives a better understanding of who is talking about your brand, identifies influencers in your industry, and allows you to run sentiment analysis on the results. My favorite feature is, of course, the brand mentions. Really simple to set up. Set up your keywords and you can start using it today. Speaking of social listening, we've been diving into natural language processing quite a bit at Growth Tribe recently, specifically with sentiment analysis. One great place to find data on your competitors is their Facebook fan pages. Thanks to David Sherlock for sharing a playbook on how to extract and neatly organize all comments on a Facebook page into a CSV file. Now, speaking of data sets, do your data sets sometimes feel a little bit empty? Last week, I fell in love with this API. It's called an IP address to income API. It's only available in USA for data regulation laws in Europe. But if some of your customers are in the US, you can now predict what their average income is based on their IP address. Check it out. It's really cool. I found this API on an API marketplace, which Jim shared. Go and check out the marketplace. There's a lot of free APIs for data enrichments and a lot of other purposes. It's got everything from face recognition APIs to a random cute kitten image generator. Meow. That was weird. Oh, and by the way, we want to thank you guys for all the support you're showing in the comments. Your kind words are giving us a huge push to keep these videos coming. As we all know, UX is just as important as marketing and analytics for growth. So thanks to Stefan for sharing this really cool article on mobile UX. The main finding here were strong visualizations of how users hold their mobile devices so that you can put the most important CTAs and elements in the easy green zones. Here's three ways to hold your phone: the one-handed, the cradled, the two-handed. And this one's particularly interesting as they're breaking down by type of iPhone. You probably don't want to put the important stuff in the red zone here. Speaking of user experiences, chatbots are still trending. Thanks to Jim for sharing landbot.io, where you can create a chatbot landing page without a single line of code. Okay, let's talk about a completely different subject: email marketing. Thanks to Luke for sharing this website, subjectline.com. Basically, you put your subject line in there and it ranks it, it scores it based on a large number of parameters. Pretty cool. Check it out. Now onto some recent content marketing gold from Noah Kagan. Noah Kagan's team studied 1 million subject lines to give us a breakdown on what works and what doesn't work. So in here, you've got top headline phrases that work really well on Facebook, the worst headline phrases that don't work on Facebook. You can also see some top phrases starting headlines, some of the top phrases ending headlines. So for example, you should start your headlines with "will make you" or "this is why." And you should never use phrases like "control of your" or "your own business" or "work for you." It's even got a really fun analysis of which specific numbers you should use inside headlines. Okay, now let's do a little bit of reading from one of our favorite heads of growth, Guillaume Caban from segment.com. If you're unhappy with your lead generation effort, check out Segment's Mad Scientist Secrets for Driving Growth. You can learn how their VP of Growth uses his collect, analyze, and act framework to accelerate growth. Speaking of Guillaume, he and a number of amazing speakers will be at our online International Growth Summit taking place at the end of this month. You can see the dates here and you can go into the description to register for free. It's all completely free and we'll show you how to optimize every single part of your funnel. Okay, now let's continue reading with one of my favorite blogs online from the Nielsen Norman Group. The NN Group recently published a study on the most hated ad format structured by ad type and device. This is gold for anybody doing outbound. Now, just because it's the most hated formats doesn't mean it's the ones that don't work, but it's still interesting to see which formats really annoy users. Okay, now let's dive into some analytics with another tool which we've started using about 3 weeks ago. Jim shared Klipfolio, which integrates all your data into main dashboards for your teams or clients. There's hundreds of integrations ready to plug in. This is the most customizable dashboard tool in the market we've seen so far. If you're looking to take dashboards to the next level, Klipfolio is the way to go. Speaking of data, I don't know if you saw this article, it's pretty scary stuff. The Republican National Committee, the RNC, was responsible for the largest leak of voter information in history. Sensitive information of 198 million voters, meaning almost all of them, was made public and ready for download, conveniently in CSV format, for 12 whole days. The database included data on each individual's political issues, ethnicity, religion, but also things like who reluctantly voted for Hillary Clinton, or who was in favor of the Affordable Care Act, and was used to power power Trump's presidential victory. So the database was used by the RNC to group voters into target clusters with names such as flag and family Republicans, tax and terrorism moderates, to then micro-target these people according to their likings. Okay, now if you can't get your hands on 198 million voters' data, here's another option for you. Thanks to Quinton for sharing Lucia, it's a person API that lets you look up personal data based on a name, company, and its domain. This tool can get you people's locations, email addresses, phone numbers, and even social media usernames. Another pearl shared by Quinton is anyleads.com. It can help you close your next hire or sales deal much faster than before. The tool finds you all email addresses and phone numbers ever related to a LinkedIn profile. They even found Quinton's Australian phone number that he used 7 years ago. This can be incredibly powerful for cold calling and outbound as well. Oh, and while we're talking about LinkedIn, Yob found an awesome playbook to bypass in-mail limitation. If you're on a business plan, you can usually go up to 40 messages per month. But if you need to send more but can't afford to pay for them, this is the way to go. Simply send people personalized connection requests. They'll get the message and you won't need to pay. The catch here is that you're limited to 300 characters. But if you follow these instructions shared by Yob, you'll be able to send as many characters as you want. Cool, now let's do a little bit of theory. If you're selling a really innovative technical solution, you probably want to target technology innovators in your early days. Technology early adopters tend to hang out on Hacker News. And thanks to Visual Capitalist for sharing this beautiful study of what people on Hacker News are probably talking about right now. It's really interesting to see what technology early adopters are talking about at the moment. And now for a little bit of myth busting. I'm really tired of hearing this myth that 8 out of 10 startups don't make it past their first year. There's no data to back this up at all. In fact, we found contradictory data because 55% of small companies make it into their fifth year. Check out this nice little animation that was shared by Quinton, and it debunks this annoying myth of 8 out of 10 startups failing. What we learn here is that persistence is key, and every extra year you stay alive increases your chances of survival. Now for another little tool, thanks to Luke for sharing AppTweet. This is a tool to boost your app downloads. Luke found that it was the only ASO tool that finds the exact Apple search popularity for English, US, UK, Australian, and New Zealand keyword. And it's the only ASO tool that shows you which apps bid for a specific keyword and all the keywords an app is currently bidding for. Okay, and here's the book recommendation for this episode. Brynn Yolson and McAfee's first book, The Second Machine Age, was mind-blowing. Now they're back with a second book called Machine Platform Crowd, Harnessing Our Digital Future. And it's a beautiful exploration of the current implications of new technologies and new trends on our economy. Okay, thanks a lot for listening. We've actually decided to add a new section and we want to know if it's interesting for you. Basically, put all your questions that you'd like answered inside the comments and we'll see if the questions are interesting, if we can actually answer the questions, and if we should make this a regular part of our series. Thanks a lot and see you in a couple of weeks.